Chuck was sworn to. Thanks. Yeah.
I have to smoke forward and backwards and stuff.
It's always nice. Have you got a lens that can go close up on that? Does that get in the way?
It's fine.
So what I'm going to do, which I should have been doing yesterday, is a cross-handed bottle. Cross-handled bottle. It's a bottle that I think is derived from the organ of some animal and was first made in leather or skin. The first person, or the first time I saw it, was that a customer came to me and asked me to make one of these pots that his father had dug up in the Euphrates River, which is kind of southeast Europe. To Turkey, that kind of direction. And so I played around with it and I came up with a bottle that was made in a different way from his, and it was very leathery, it was baggy, and you could understand how stitched, handled, and so on. And it was probably the belly or bladder or something of some animal back. So anyway, I'll make my interpretation of that in clay. Now, I often make the neck first, which from your point of view is probably not the best way to see it, but usually the necks of pots are made last. Thank you. nice proper. This part, unlike some other parts, rather critical in that I want it to look rather sacky or leathery. So chosen a tool that can really get in under and bring about this rather leathery effect. Through a cylinder.
Is the base somewhat like your GP bowls though? You know, it's rounded down there.
Yes, it is. It is a little bit like that down here. It's quite right. But I throw a cylinder first and then I kind of push it out from the inside to get that same, almost beginnings of a catenary that increases as it goes down under. That's what I'm after. No, I think this is all right. Just check it in a minute. Sometimes they're a little narrower than the foot. This one's a little fatter down there, I think. Right. The throwing part is finished. Oh, I need a rag. It's not rags. Over there. That's it. Thank you. So this is the stage which just grab it like that and push it. If you watch that circle at the top, it suddenly goes like that. And then I join up one end like so. And of course, this is the best stage to join it at because it's exactly the same moisture for the two bits you join together. So, it would be tomorrow before it is dry, but this will be pared down, and this neck put on, and the handle curved in nicely, and I'll show you that tomorrow. So that's the cross handle bottle, and of course you can have many different shapes. I sometimes do a flared one, I do four narrow ones, like the one that you've got, Kathy. Here we are. Right, now shall I just do the supper plate? Slightly firmer clay, possibly, than I would use for throwing normally, because of the method of which I take it off the wheel. Okay. I'm centering it now, and I'm preparing it in such a way that it's shaped up for the next movement. I'm keeping it in the bowl shape while I'm still shaping it, and then I can always flatten it, but if you go straight out to the shallow shape to begin with, you go too far, it's very difficult to bring it back. And it's useful if you can use your hand like that and supporting it on the outside with the right hand. This is the plate when you're feeling hoodly. Right, there we are. Supper plate. Twisted wire. Just throw some water down there and hope that I can aquaplane it off. Fingers under, it's aquaplaning, catch it as it comes off the wheel, and I compensate down carefully. That. Anyway, you're going to flip it up the next day and turn it so it will level off. Now, GP bow, I'm doing all the things on the wheel head first, and then I'll put bats down. My standard GP bow, which I've been throwing for about 23 or 4 years now. It's varied a little bit because of mold.